Here is my setup. Two cups, one bin, one mirror. Between this, I'll be able to make sure I'm staring directly at the camera, prop my camera up, and make sure it's at head level so I can record a video to give you a bit of an insight into a bit of an idea I had the other night and kind of a tip. So without any further ado, let's go. Back, taking a phone call, done the intros, let's get on with it. So the other night I was at a shoot and I was shooting Fatboy Slim. And one of the things I always try to do, regardless of where I go and if I know people or don't know people, is always make a point of introducing myself to people and saying hello to people and letting them know that you're there and just doing the intros. So I put my kit down, I was walking around, I see a couple of guys with a gimbal and a camera, and obviously put my two and two together and thought these guys must be the video crew or putting together the video. So I went over and just introduced myself and I was like, hey, how you doing? I'm Luke, nice to meet you. I'm shooting the photography tonight. I guess you guys are doing a video. They said, yeah, sure, we're doing a video, all the rest of it. And just done a warm intro and then started speaking to him, and he, you know, made it clear that he was just starting out and trying to build a portfolio. And was asking some questions like, how does he get started? You know, what should he charge? How much did I charge? All that sort of jazz. And I gave him some advice. And the bit of advice I gave him is a bit of advice that I've used from the beginning and will continue to use throughout the rest of my career. And so I said to him, if you want to build your portfolio and get exposure, what you should do tonight is just shoot some B-roll of all of the artists playing. So basically just shoot a load of B-roll for all of the artists that's playing, and then just pull together a tiny little B-roll, like a 10-20 second B-roll of that artist, you know, sort of them playing, a crowd, hands in the air, all the rest of it, and supply that content to the artist. Now obviously giving it to Fatboy Slim's probably not going to work because he's hierarchy, he's way up here, but some of the smaller artists and the artists developing to that level, you know, of course if a videographer says, hey look, I done a 20 second or a 10 second video of you the other night, would you be happy sharing it and credit me? Of course they're going to say yes. 100% they're going to say yes. If they didn't, they're an idiot, and you know, they're probably not going to last long in the music career. So I said that's a good way to get exposure, and I used to do that and I still do actually. So what I will do is whenever I'm at an event, I will make a point of taking pictures of everybody at that event, and then I will supply those images to those artists and just ask for a credit. And it really is as simple as that. So for instance, if I turn up to a night and there's, you know, six DJs on the lineup, one of them being the headliner, which, you know, if they share it, say for instance Carl Cock, if he shares it, that's his discretion, isn't it? But some of the other artists lower down and sort of aspiring artists, of course they're going to share it, and of course they're going to credit you. So you then have potentially five additional avenues to share your work through, rather than just sharing it on yours. You can share it across multiple platforms, and it's so easy to do. You're already there, you're already taking pictures. How hard is it to just pull some of these images in and supply those to the DJs? Now some people will be like, oh well, they didn't pay me. And that mentality will stop you in your tracks and stop you progressing in your career, because that's your mentality, you know. I recently watched a video with Rankin, and he has a video of a guy called Steve Barrett from The Social Chain. And he basically is talking, so Rankin says he still does stuff for free. And the way he describes it is he calls it planting a seed. He's like, I'll plant seeds everywhere. Some of them will start to, you know, spurt in a week, some of them will be a year, some of them will be 2 years, but eventually they will turn into something. And that's exactly what happens here. You know, you are planting a seed. So one, you're forging a relationship with the DJ. Two, your work is getting pushed to a wider audience, aka their audience, which is obviously, you know, the demographic is going to be the same. You're taking pictures at a music event, they're a DJ, you know, the people that are going to be looking at them are going to be interested in your content because it's all relevant and they're probably going to follow you. So you're building your socials as well. You know, it's an absolute no-brainer, and you're planting a seed that is going to develop, and it will keep on developing. It may even develop to the point where, because you've done a favor for that DJ, when they need some video work or they need some photography work, they come back to you and say, oh yeah, do you know what, that guy was really nice that time, and that's stuck in my memory, so that's the person I'm going to ask. And I you know, that's how I started building my portfolio. I kept on seeing that my social media platform at the beginning was quite weak, and it was a case of how do I bolster this up, how do I get more from it? So I was like, well, let's just use the social media of some of these artists. Like when I first started doing stuff for Abode, those guys had amazing social medias in comparison to me. So I made a point of, you know, sharing the work that I'd shot for them so they could share it on their socials and push out, and I still do it now. So one of the things I can offer to people now is because my social medias have, or my social media accounts have got to a you know a decent size. When I shoot artists, I can say, hey, you know, I'll promote you on my socials. You know, I'll pop pictures out on you and I'll tag you in. You know, and if you can do the same, that'll be amazing. So we're helping each other and we're pushing each other out. And you know, it's a really, really, really simple trick to do, and it will pay huge amounts of dividends later on. And you know, maybe immediately, but also later on in your photography, videography career. So my tip is, if you're at an event and you're shooting an event, make a point of taking pictures of every single one of the artists on the roster, or shoot some B-roll of the artists on the roster and supply it to the artist directly in return for being credited. That simple. If you're shooting the gig for free to start off with, of course you could see it as like, oh God, I'm losing money, you're not, you're forging relationships which will pay dividends later on. But if you are being paid for the gig, you're being paid for the gig, you know, you supply the images to the person that's paid you, first of all, and make sure they are happy, you know, and they're happy. Once those images are put out there, you then share them with the artist, because what the artist will tend to do is, they'll end up getting like really poor copies or taking screenshots of your images. So then they share your images in really low resolution and they look pants. So rather than taking that risk, supply them directly to the artist and allow yourself to be promoted through their channels. And what's going on in the background is you forge that relationship. It's literally a no-brainer. So that came about because I was speaking to a videographer who's just starting out in the industry, and it's probably my one tip. Look, you know, if you're gonna take any advice from me or sort of take anything from any YouTube videos out there, if you wanna progress in the dance music industry, I don't know what it's like for other industries, but if you wanna progress in that industry, 110%, that is the best way to do it. So hopefully you found that useful. As ever, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. I will always produce more. If you've got any questions, if you think, oh yeah, that's quite a cool tip, this guy might actually know something, I've got some questions, pop some questions below and I'll be more than happy to answer them. And also check out some of my other videos. Really appreciate it. Speak to you soon.